Pokemon Let's Go isn't only for kids. In fact, it's so much more. We were all wrong about this game. And to prove that we mean it, we have this time teamed up with a trustworthy Poketuber all the way from UK for this episode of Inside Pokemon Let's Go.
Pokemon Let's Go struggled to convince us, despite the returning of tailing Pokemon and no random encounters, as these also meant no regular wild Pokemon battles. It also didn't help that the E3 2018 demo was underwhelming and left much to be desired. Then, to make the situation even worse, we learned that gym leader battles required Pokemon that said leader and Pokemon are weak to. All of this didn't exactly fill us with optimism for this title until late July. Luckily, since the beginning of August, the Pokemon Company has continued to release new and way more convincing Let's Go trailers, introducing a comprehensive list of new and returning mechanics that will add extra layers to the game. These include the confirmation of Mega Evolutions, battles against legendary Pokemon, Alolan forms of Kanto Pokemon, new moves for Pikachu and Eevee, minigames in the Go Park, new traveling techniques, a fully realized Team Rocket, a brand new legendary Pokemon, and finally, as icing on the cake, we have Birdkeeper Toby to take us over his 3-hour-long recent hands-on experience with the game.
So without further ado, let's go straight into the Mega Evolutions found in the game. Along with the reveal of a brand new Pokemon, this must be the greatest announcement for the game this far. For anyone wondering, Mega Evolutions are closely tied to the lore and timeline specifics of Pokemon, originally introduced and explained through the gameplay and plot of Pokemon X and Y in 2013. Since then, the mechanic has been implemented in Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, and then on a lesser scale in Sun and Moon and Ultra Sun and Moon, where Z-moves took center stage. Luckily, in Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee, Mega Evolutions return in a grand style and for the first time in a Kanto-based remake reimagination. Obviously, only Kanto Pokemon Mega Evolutions will be used, limiting the number of Mega Evolutions compared to X and Y, but so far we have gotten the confirmation of a rather impressive list of Mega Evolutions. These include Mega Venusaur, Mega Charizard X and Y, Mega Blastoise, Mega Kangaskhan, and Mega Gyarados, among many, are just a few of the ones that we can look forward to Mega Evolve come November 16.
Moving on, one of the greatest concerns regarding Pokemon Let's Go is the lack of regular wild Pokemon battles. Seeing this, it came as a great relief when it was confirmed that all Kanto legendary Pokemon will involve battles prior to catching. Articuno, Zapdos, Moltres, and Mewtwo will obviously be battle highlights in Pokemon Let's Go, along with all trainer, gym leader, and Elite Four battles. And if that wasn't enough, another legendary battle is brewing up for Pokemon Let's Go. The Pokemon Let's Go reveal trailer teased a surprise new Pokemon, and a few weeks ago, the Pokemon Company revealed the latest legendary in the world of Pokemon, Meltan. Wait. Is that bolty one-eyed thing supposed to really be a legendary? Come on, it looks like the Pokemon equivalent of London 2012's mascots, Wenlock and Mandeville. Anyhow, just like with the other legendaries in the game, in order to catch this mythical steel-type legendary Pokemon, you will first have to battle and weaken it. Overall, a welcome inclusion, though a little odd for Kanto. Wonder if this mysterious Pokemon will tie somehow to the plot or lore of Pokemon Let's Go. We will certainly find that out really soon as we're getting closer and closer to the launch on November 16th. A brand new Pokemon is always exciting, but we should also not forget that both Pikachu and Eevee will be able to learn brand new exclusive moves, like Pikachu's Splishy Splash and Eevee's Bouncy Bubble, Buzzy Buzz, and Sizzly Slide. On top of that, Game Freak has also implemented brand new special moves for Pikachu and Eevee in this title. Fittingly called Partner Powers, these moves are indicated by either Pikachu or Eevee by holding a Joy-Con on the screen. Unleashing this power of your bond with your starter Pokemon has a devastating effect on your opponent.
Overall, it appears to serve a similar purpose as the Z-moves did in Sun and Moon and Ultra Sun and Moon. but only with your partner Pokemon. Is this a way for Game Freak to make you use Pikachu or Eevee throughout the game? It looks like it could be the case. Speaking of partner powers, Pikachu and Eevee are no Charizard, Onix, Lapras or Pidgeotto. You can't ride, fly or sail on them, and Game Freak knew this really well. So for Let's Go, they introduced new ways of getting around or across known as secret techniques. From the classic cut to surfing the waters and using inflatable balloons with Eevee on the steering wheel to fly across Kanto. All of these are welcome additions that, along with the petting, grooming and customization options in the game, will help build a tight bond to either Pikachu or Eevee across the game. On top of that, it will also make the experience much closer to the Pokemon anime, which is rather fitting seeing that the anime inspired much of Pokemon Yellow to begin with. So we have an Ash and Green-like trainer, a rival that is supposed to be the equivalent of Gary Oak, though he isn't, Brock and Misty as gym leaders, so what is missing then?
Prepare for trouble and make it double. Team Rocket's eternal losers, Jesse and James, are back for the first time in a Pokemon mainline game since, well, Pokemon Yellow. Pokemon Yellow was many people's first Pokemon title, so seeing all of these taken care of really makes positive in regard that this game will be a success when it comes to capture the spirit of both Yellow and the anime. Gladly, Pokemon Let's Go doesn't only rely on the first generation, but has also found meaningful ways to integrate Pokemon Go and Alolan features to this game. The most evident beyond the controversial way of catching wild regular Pokemon is the Go Park. These can be visited to import Kanto Pokemon and Pokemon Go for use in Pokemon Let's Go, or to play minigames to earn more candies or evolve your Pokemon faster. A nice recent reveal was that we will also be able to import Alolan form Kanto Pokemon, and by importing these and other Pokemon from Go, gain rewards and candies. These are all good incentives to bring those of us who didn't play Pokemon Go on a regular basis back to the app.
Let's Go is filled with all these kind of small and big features, like using Pokemon to find secrets or online trading that make the experience of this game much more whole. Yes, it is a shame that Mew, as one of the only Pokemon that can learn close to any move, is locked behind the Pokeball Plus, but in return there's so much more to look forward to. But do not take our word, instead listen to our good friend Birdkeeper Toby, who has played the first 3 hours of the game. But before we get over to him, make sure to subscribe to the Commonwealth Realm and Birdkeeper Toby, and we will see you at the end of the video.
Hey, Pokemon Masters and Commonwealth Realm, thank you for having me over here, and I actually have something to say about Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee. And maybe it's a slightly different perspective, because last month, little humble brag here, I actually got the chance to go to the Pokemon headquarters in London and play bits of the game that had never been played before. I had already played the E3 demo at a couple of events, but this in particular was something special. We got to play the game, and granted, I was in Pokemon headquarters, and we were surrounded by, you know, Pokemon Company people, so the feeling was good in general. But without a doubt, I don't think that's what made me love the game. I think the game is what made me love the game. It was fun to play. It was a joyful experience. Now, in regards to the criticism that it's a very easy game, I can't really comment, because I played Pallet Town up to the end of Pewter City, the tutorial section of the game. And given that I've been playing the Pokemon series for over 20 years, yes, it was an easy part of the game for me. But I was assured by the reps who work there at Pokemon Company, they said it without even prompting. They were like, by the way, it gets way harder. I didn't have to say, hey, this is a concern I have. They were just like, oh, this gets harder, by the way. And actually, catching some of the rarer Pokemon was quite difficult. Beedrill popped up on screen and it was zipping around the screen everywhere. Keeping track of it, deciding if I should use a raspberry or not to prevent it from fleeing, the fact that it even could flee from a Pokemon battle. That added a level of intensity to the battle that I had not experienced before playing Pokemon. And the fact that it was catching Pokemon and not wild Pokemon battles actually added a sense of it being fresh for me. Like in a lot of past Pokemon games, I'll just walk through the grass and if I encounter something, I'll just hit the flee button. I'm not actually interested in battling it. I already have to battle all the trainers' Pokemon and I'm gonna encounter every trainer anyway because that's the way I like to play the game. I like to battle everyone. I don't also want to have to deal with random encounters. But the very fact that the encounters are different to the trainer battles, because now it's about catching the Pokemon and if I want to do that, if I want to get that experience, if I want to get that Pokemon, it actually made the playing experience incredibly refreshing. All I can say is 100% of what I've played of Let's Go, both at the Pokemon Company and the demo, I've enjoyed. And in fact, everyone who was there that day playing the demo enjoyed themselves. And at the end of the day, isn't enjoying the game you're playing what playing video games is even about? And if you're looking for a more hardcore Pokemon experience, Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon are still the competitive standard for the year. And a more traditional, conventional Pokemon game will be coming out next year. So if you don't want this fun little extra in the meantime, then don't worry about it. There'll be new Pokemon stuff right around the corner.
Thank you, Toby, for that great insights. Summing up, as you can see, Pokemon Let's Go has its advantages and disadvantages. Luckily, the advantages heavily outweigh the disadvantages. And in the end, this game may not be for everyone, but for everyone else who is looking to a real hardcore Pokemon experience, we're getting it only next year. This game is for drawing in new players and Pokemon Go players, but also, as you heard, adding a little bit of challenge for us hardcore players. So if you enjoyed this video, then make sure to like it and to not miss any future videos on the Nintendo Switch, Pokemon Let's Go, and then make sure to subscribe to the Commonwealth Realm and press that shiny notification bell to not miss any of our Pokemon Let's Go and Nintendo Switch news videos. Also make sure to subscribe to Birdkeeper Toby, as we did a video with him on his channel, which we highly recommend you check out at the end of this video in the end card. Finally, we want to thank all our patrons, and in particular Royal Producer Kenata Ali, for their support to the realm. You can join their ranks too by heading over to patreon.com/commonrealm. Until the next video, girls and guys, this was Conrad Varnes of the Commonwealth Realm, and make sure to check out the video we did with Birdkeeper Toby on his channel.